श्री भगवानुवाच हन्तते कथयिष्यामि देव्याह्यात्मविभूतयः प्राधान्यतः कुरु श्रेष्ठ नास्त्यन्तो विस्तरस्य मे।
श्री भगवानुवाच कृष्ण स्पीक्स नाउ answers after being silent for all these verses 12 to 18 Arjuna has been blabbering something or the other. Krishna keeps quiet, and this in itself has power when you have knowledge and you keep quiet. So the combination of knowledge and silence, if you don't know and you keep quiet, there's no big deal about it. You have immense knowledge and yet you keep quiet, tremendous patience, and that in itself is curative. So he says, yes, I will speak to you of my pradhanyata vibhutim, predominant glories, divine glories. And why pradhanyata? Why main, chief? Because there is no end to my pervasiveness. So Kuru Shrestha, he addresses Arjuna as Kuru Shrestha, meaning the best among the Kurus, means best among Indians. And there is a hint of sarcasm there, because at the end of it, what is he asking? He's only asking for manifestations. He's not asking for the original. Why are you asking for fakes? If you have an original painting, you have access to the original. Why would you want a fake? That's what he's asking. So, and then he says, Pradhanyata, I will tell you the predominant, the best, so that even the person who is at a lower level of spiritual development will get inspired. See, even an ordinary person gets inspired by the mighty Himalayas, the Ganga. When you go to the higher reaches, Rishikesh, and you go and see this aarti at the banks of the river, even the most materialistic person gets inspired. So he's talking about the best so that he can carry everyone along with him. But as you evolve spiritually, you don't need to go to Gangotri and Yamunotri and Amarnath and all these places. You can be here in Mumbai and get highly inspired by a sunset, a sunrise, the full moon. You look at a flower, a fruit, you can get inspired. And at the highest level of evolution, you don't need any expressions. Again, he's saying it because Atman is truly the best in everything. And also when he's trying to establish an identification, he's talking about the best so that it's easier for you to connect. You know, it's like this. When you are matchmaking for a young girl, and you're introducing her to prospective boys, what will you say? Say, oh, he's intelligent, he's got a good job, he's good looking, this, that, and the other. He might be a little short-tempered. You don't say that right up front, because she'll reject straight away. So when you're matchmaking, you bring out the best. Now once the identification, once she falls in love, she'll take all the rest. That's the idea. Next verse.